there. My name is Jacques, and I live and work in Kelowna, British Columbia, Canada. And I'm very happy to submit this short video for the MOOC on MOOC course. I hope you like it and that it fosters some discussion. I want to first thank the wonderful people who organized this course at IIT and the Commonwealth of Learning. I think what they did is a generous venture, it's innovative, and it's a pretty bold thing to do as well. My background is that of a consultant in the field of educational technology, training, and online learning. Over the years, I've had the chance to work for organizations in the nonprofit, the private, the government, and the academic sector. And so I've had the chance to see online learning from quite a few different viewpoints. The title of this video is MOOCs: The Good, the Bad, and the Ugly. It's partly because I live in Western Canada, in the interior of British Columbia, and we have quite a few cowboys here, and I love sappy Western movies. But mainly, it's because I have mixed feelings about MOOCs. I'll start with the bad, however, and then I'll move on with the ugly, but I want to end with the good, with what I think is good about MOOCs and the MOOC movement. Okay, first the bad. The big problem that I think I have with MOOCs, and I'm certainly not alone in this, is that to me, it is a concept that is contributing more and more to confusion in the field of online and open learning, and possibly less and less quality. Early in the course, we learned that the letters in the concept MOOC are actually all somewhat negotiable. In online learning, there's already lots of confusion about terminology and concepts. It's already difficult to educate clients about just how to do good online learning, about optimal strategies to use, and optimal tactics for developing good quality online learning. With a fuzzy concept like MOOC and all the hype surrounding it, I think there's even more confusion in the field now, and I don't think that's a very good thing. Some of the actual MOOC courses out there are great, but we didn't really need the concept, I don't think. All this energy would have been better spent, I think, helping to support individuals and organizations who want to do online learning and aren't exactly sure how to go about it in a strategic and effective way. The distinction between so-called connectionist CMOOCs and more expository XMOOCs, in my opinion, just adds more to the confusion. CMOOCs, on the one hand, are to me a true learning innovation, whereas XMOOCs to me seem more like an administrative innovation with very little design actually built into it. This is where the ugly comes in, I think. With all of the hype surrounding MOOCs, many content experts, institutions, and organizations seem to be launching themselves very quickly into online learning, feeling they will somehow be left behind. And the results should be kind of expected. A few really good MOOC courses, but a greater number of probably not very good, maybe even really bad, low-quality courses and content. For some reason, this poorly defined negotiable concept of MOOC seems to be leading many enthusiasts to think that learning design principles can also be somehow negotiated away. So this leads to things like this idea or this principle that 5 to 10 minute videos, kind of like this one, are the best and optimal way to deliver content in a MOOC, which really is hogwash. But it's not all bad and ugly, of course. All this attention on MOOCs has brought online learning to the corridors of power, and more and more people are talking about it at higher and higher levels. Now, that's a good thing. It's also pushing educational institutions to review and maybe relax their sometimes rigid structures, which is also a good thing. And all the global competition for students may well eventually lead to better and better quality. At least it should. MOOCs are also pushing forth the development and research in, and hopefully investment in, open educational resources. which I think is likely one of the big reasons why the Commonwealth of Learning is supporting this concept. Just a final thought from my fellow students. If MOOCs are the solution, what's the problem? Thank you.